Good morning students, today's class we will see the solved question paper of October 2019 of 2016 scheme. So the first question was, explain the parts of WGI system with help of neat label diagram and they added number of esophagus. For the diagram you can refer to your textbooks or to the pictures I have given here, but we will see the Norton esophagus. GIT consists of mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. The accessory digestive organs include teeth, tongue, salivary glands and exocrine part of pancreas, liver and gallbladder. Esophagus is a muscular tube of 23 cm in length. It extends from the laryngeal pharynx to its cardiac end of the stomach. Esophagus have three parts, that is cervical, that is 4 cm, thoracic nearly 20 cm and abdominal nearly 1.25 cm. The esophagus lung, that is related to the posterior trachea in the upper part and thoracic aorta in the left and posterior in the lower part. Esophagus passes through the esophageal orifice of diaphragm and enters the abdominal cavity. It presents four normal constrictions which are important during instrumentation breach as a pharyngeo-esophageal junction that is 15 cm away from the lower incisors at the point where it crossed by the arch of aorta, that is 21.5 cm away from the lower incisors, and at the point where it crossed by the left bronchus, that is 27.5 cm away from the incisors, and the point where it passes through the diaphragm, that is 40 cm away from the incisors. Applied anatomy include dysphagia, that is difficulty in swallowing, gastroesophageal reflex, carcinoma of the esophagus and esophageal varices which occur during portal hypertension. Explain structure of a neuron, add a knotted neuroganglia. This is the picture of a neuron. A neuron, also known as a neuron or a nerve cells, is electrically excitable cell that communicates with other cells via special connections known as synapses. The axon and dendrites and filaments that extrude from it. Dendrites, typically a branch of profusely and extend a few hundred micrometers from the soma. The axon leaves the soma at a swelling called axon hillock and travels as far as 1 meter in human or more other species. It branches but usually maintain a constant diameter. At the furthest tip of the axon branches, at the axon terminals, which are neurons, can transmit signal across the synapse to another cell. Neuroglia are the group of supportive cells for neurons. Further, they maintain the myelin sheath, provide nutrient support. Moreover, they also retain hemostasis. It is within the CNS and PNS. The main function to protect and maintain optimum functioning of the nervous system. These cells are commonly called glia or neuroglia. Further, they link the central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. The types of neuroglia include oligodendrites, astrocytes, microglia and epidermal cells, but also known as glial cells. Microglia. They are also phagocytic cells. They engulf pathogens, thus serve as a defensive role within the nervous system. Further, it has a flexible shape. This form tends to keep changing, mainly after it has engulfed to a foreign body. They are present throughout the brain and spinal cord. Oligodendrocytes. These are the glial cells present in the CNS. Further, they help in making of the myelin sheath, the sheath that seizes the axon of the neurons. Astrocytes, they get name from astro meaning star and cyte meaning cell. They are star-shaped cells in the CNS. They provide structural integrity. They fill up spaces between neurons. Moreover, they also have tiny little feet called perimuscular end feet. They wind around the blood vessels once they constitute the blood-brain barrier. Epidermal cells, they are also three variants. Thus, they are epidermocytes, tanycytes and choroidal epithelial cells. Similarly, these cells have a part of CNS. They deal with aspects of CSF. The epidermoids promotes free movement of molecules. It does so between neurons and the cerebrospinal fluid. Further, the tanycytes respond to alterations in the hormonal level. It does within the blood-derived hormones. Neuroglia functions. It offers essential nutrients. It includes oxygen to the neurons. Next, it helps to create a myelin sheath. The sheath is important for the functioning of nervous system. It promotes and speeds up the electrical impulse conduction. It does so by the wrapping around axons. Further, it also helps to maintain hemostasis within the neurons. Hemostasis is how the cell maintains stable environment despite of circumstance disturbances. It destroys pathogen. It helps to protect the neurons. Finally, it also provides structural stability. It forms support structures that neurons can inhabit in. Name the male reproductive organ and anatomy of testes. This is a picture of the male reproductive organs and testes. Testes are located within the scrotum. Their epididyme is situated on the posterior lateral aspect of each testicle. Commonly, left testicle is slightly lower than the right. The suspended from the abdomen by a spermatic cord, collection of vessels, nerves and ducts that supply the testes. Situated in the scrotal sac by spermatic cord and covered by scrotal layers, the scrotal layer include dartos muscle and crest master muscle. Sperms cannot be produced at the body temperature. This test is situated scrotum, which produces temperature about 3 degrees cooler. Length 5 cm, breadth is nearly 2.5 cm and thickness is around 3 cm and weight is nearly 10 to 14 grams. Test is divided 200 to 300 lobules, numerous septa that arise from mediastinum testis. Within each lobule, there are 2 to 3 seminiferous tubules. Coverings of testes. Outer cover is tunica vaginalis. Middle is tunica albuginea and inner tunica vasculosa. Arterial supply of testes is by testicular artery, a branch of abdominal aorta. Venous drainage is veins emerging from testes is from a pampiniform plexus. This plexus surrounds the testicular artery and vas deferens. These veins condense to form testicular vein, which drains into the left renal vein. Lymphatic drainage. Lymphatics form testes drain to pre-aortic and para-aortic nodes at the level of L2. Nerve supply. Testes are supplied by sympathetic fibers arising from T10 spinal segment. Structure of breast. Breast is a modified sweat gland. Adult female breasts have a base, nipple, areola and axillary tail. Base, it is circular. Vertically, it extends from 2nd to 6th rib, the mid-clavicular line. Horizontally, it extends from lateral border of sternum to mid-axillary line. Nipple, it is a conical projection below the center of the breast. It is pierced by 15 to 30 lactiferous ducts. It is circularly and longitudinally arranged in smooth muscle fibers. Areola. It is a pigmented circular area around the base of the nipple. Outer margins of the areola has modified into sebaceous glands. Arterial supply. Breast supplied by lateral mammary branches, perforating branches from 2nd, 3rd and 4th intercostal arteries and superior thoracic artery. Veins drain into axillary, internal thoracic and intercostal veins. Nerve supply. The intercostal nerves and sympathetic fibers supply the skin and blood vessels respectively. Lymphatic drainage. About 75% of lymph from mammary glands drain into the axillary nodes. Axillary tail or spence. It is a tail-like projection from upper quadrant of the breast to the axilla. When enlarged, it may be mistaken for the axillary node or lymphoma. This way, pancreas. Pancreas is a gland that's partially endocrine, partially exocrine and endocrine. It lies transversely across the posterior abdominal wall. It has four parts: head, neck, body and tail. Head is enlarged. It lies in the concavity of duodenum. Neck is slightly constricted part between the head and body. Portal vein formed behind the neck of the pancreas by the union of superior mesenteric and splenic vein. The body extends from the neck to the tail. It is elongated, passes upwards towards the left. The tail of pancreas is the narrow left end of the pancreas. It reaches the ileum of the spleen. It lies along the splenic vessels to the ileo-renal segment. The adult, it is nearly around 15 to 20 cm long, weighing nearly 90 grams and 3 cm broad. Arterial supply is by branches of splenic artery and branches of superior and inferior pancreatic or duodenal arteries. Parasympathetic and sympathetic fibers innervate pancreas. They reach it via blood vessels. Updated anatomy. Deficiency of insulin causes diabetes mellitus. Carcinoma of the head of the pancreas is common. Pressure over the bile duct causes obstructive jaundice. Pressure over the portal vein leads to ascites. Annular pancreas is a congenital anomaly of pancreas which encircles the duodenum and it may obstruct the duodenum. Accessory pancreatic tissue may be seen in Meckel's diverticula. This is a picture of a pancreas. Structure of urinary bladder. It is a hollow, muscular organ which functions as a reservoir for urine receives from the kidney and to discharge it out periodically. Four angles like apex, neck and two lateral angles. Four surfaces, base, two inferior lateral and superior surface. Empty the bladder in adult situated within the true pelvis. When distended, it rises the abdominal cavity and becomes an abdominal pelvic organ. Capacity of a normal capacity is 200 to 300 cc. Blood supply is by branches of internal iliac artery corresponding to vein from a plexus and drain into internal iliac vein. Nerve supply vesicular plexus composed of sympathetic and parasympathetic fibers in the inner vein bladder. Parasympathetic fibers are from S2, S3, S4 segments of spinal cord. Sympathetic fibers derive from L1 segment. Applied anatomy. Congenital anomalies ectopia vesica. There is a deficient in the development of anterior abdominal walls. The trigone of bladder is exposed and uretic open can be seen on it. Infection of bladder causes cystitis. Cystoscopy is done to visualize the interior of the bladder and neurological lesions of the bladder can occur due to injury of spinal cord at or above S2, S4 and S5 segments. Cancer of bladder, rupture of bladder in distant bladder in case distant bladder is in danger of rupture of bladder. And seventh question is pleura. Pleura is a serous membrane lined by a single layer of squamous cell. There are two pleural sacs, one on either side of mediastinum. Each pleural sac is invaginated by the medial side of the lung, so it has outer layer called parietal pleura and inner visceral layer of pulmonary pleura. It covers the surface of fissures of the lungs except at the helium and formally attached to the surface of the lung. It cannot be separated from it. The potential space between two layers of pleural cavity within a thin film of fluid to prevent the friction. The pulmonary pleura and the lungs are innervated by autonomous nervous system. The parietal layer is supplied by intercostal nerves and phrenic nerve. It is a pain sensitive. Applied anatomy. Inflammation of the pleura is known as pleuritic or pleurisy. It may be associated with collection of fluid in the pleural cavity. Presence of air in the pleural cavity is called pneumothorax. Penetrating injuries to the thoracic wall can lead to this condition. Presence of blood in thoracic cavity is known as hemothorax. Presence of pus in the pleural cavity is emphysema. Aspiration of any fluid from the thoracic cavity is called paracentesis. It is usually done in the sixth intercostal space in the mid-axillary line to avoid injury to other organs. The eighth question is paranasal sinus. These are the air filled suspensions of the respiratory tract following the skull bones, frontal, ethmoid, maxilla and sphenoid. The name according to the bones in which they are situated are the frontal sinus, ethmoidal sinus, maxillary sinus and sphenoidal sinus. All of them open in nasal cavity through its lateral wall. The sinuses are lined with mucous membrane that are continuous with the mucous membrane of the nasal cavity. The functions include the reduced weight. Weight of the skull, inhaled air is warmed and humidified. They add resonance to the voice and mucus secreted by the mucus gland helps to trap dust particle in inhaled air. Cilia remove the dust particle. Applied anatomy. Infection of ethmoid sinus may spread to orbit because of the medial wall of orbit is thin and fragile, so it can lead to the cellulitis. The maxillary sinus is one of most commonly infected, probably because of its opening situated superior to its floor. Since the floor of maxillary sinus and the root of maxillary molar teeth are very closely related, the removal of molar teeth may lead to formation of communication between oral cavity and maxillary sinus. All paranasal sinus are lined by mucosa, which is an extension of mucosa of the nasal cavity. The infection may spread easily, producing inflammation, swelling. This is called sinusitis. Sciatic nerve. It is the largest branch of sciatic plexus, thickest of the body. It is formed by a ventral ramae of L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. The sciatic nerve begins in the pelvis and terminates at the superior angle of popliteal fossa by dividing into tibial and common peroneal nerves. In the pelvis, the nerve lies anterior to the piriformis muscles. Enters the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen below piriformis. It lies under the cover gluteus maximus muscle. It is the longest and widest single nerve in the human body, going from the top of the leg to the foot of the posterior aspect. Sciatic nerve has no cutaneous branches for the thigh. This nerve provides connection to the nervous system for the skin of the lateral leg and ball foot, the muscles of back of the thigh, those of the leg and foot. It contains fibers from both anterior and posterior divisions of lumbosacral plexus. Deltoid muscle. It is a powerful multipinnate muscle shaped like inverted delta. It forms round contour of the shoulder because it overlaps the upper end of the humerus. It originates from anterior border and upper surface of lateral one third of clavicle, lateral border of acromion and crest of the spine of scapula. It is innervated by axillary nerve, and any fracture of the surgical neck of the humerus can severely damage the axillary nerve, and this leads to paralysis and atrophy of the deltoid muscle. And it is common site for giving intramuscular injection. Injection should be given the lower half of the muscle to avoid injury to the axillary nerve. When all its fibers contract simultaneously, that means a prime mover of arm abduction along with the frontal plane. The arm must be mainly rotated for the deltoid to have maximum effect. Classification of joints. Joints are classified there of three types: fibrous, bonds connected with the fibrous tissue; cartilages, bond connected by cartilage; synovial, articulating surface enclosed within the fluid-filled joint capsule. Classification by degree of movement. Synarthrosis, that is immobile; ambiarthrosis, slightly movable; diathrosis, that is feeling movable. Chambers of heart. Heart have four chambers: the right, the left atrium, left ventricle, right atrium and left ventricle. The right atrium receives the deoxygenated blood from the upper part of the body by superior vena cava, from the inner part by inferior vena cava, and it is going to the aortic right ventricle, from where to the pulmonary artery. It goes to the lungs for purification. After purification, it comes to the right, means left atrium, and to the left ventricle, and finally through aorta to the all of the body. Differentiate between cranial and spinal nerve. Cranial nerve, the 12 pair of cranial nerve originating from nuclei in the interior surface of the brain. It can be sensory or motor or mixed, concerned mainly with the activities associated with head and neck, designated by serial number and name. Spinal nerve, the 31 pairs of spinal nerve that leaves the vertebral canal by passing through the intervertebral foramen, purely mixed, that is both sensory and motor function, named according to the location of the spinal cord required for movement of muscles. Coronary and pulmonary circulation. Coronary artery carries oxygenated blood from the ascending aorta to supply to the heart. It composed of right and left coronary artery. Blood flow through the coronary artery during diastole. Left coronary artery larger and supplies majority of myocardium. Pulmonary circulation carries deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle to the heart to the lungs through the pulmonary artery. Composed of pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein, carries blood to in and to and fro the lungs. Thank you for listening.